Richard Reid was crowned King of the Jungle in Argentina. He was a bit of a dark horse.
Yeah, I think so, for sure. Yep. I think a lot of people will go, oh, my God!
I know, and, you know, and I think because we got to see this beautiful side of him, the side that we all know and love, but as well, he was put to the test in the toughest of trials, and he was really quite a scream to watch. Check him out.
All right, Richard.
No, no, wait. Okay, okay, okay.
Yeah?
Yep.
You okay?
Yes! God, don't yell at me, Chris.
Ah! Oh. Ah! 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 You okay?
Oh! Oh, please, dear Lord. Ah! 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 No! Ah! Mother!
That's it. Flick it. That's
Lucy.
It.
Bah! Bah! Bah!
Yes. Mother, mother, mother.
Richard, do you ever imagine that you'd have your feet in a pair of Crocs?
That was good, I'll give you that. Only the high heel kind.
It was just a joy to watch. He popped by yesterday for a quick hello, but we have him on the panel all morning. Please welcome King of the Jungle, Richard Reid.
We're going to have to share the throne, though.
Oh,
hello.
Welcome to your next throne, which is in front of the office chair.
Oh, my God, it's nice and high.
Is that
dressed up for me. I love it.
This whole thing.
Is that how you get around now?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I call Uber, and that's what they said.
Oh, wow.
Hi, guys.
How are you? It must just be surreal. Have you sort of come back down to earth?
Clearly, no, when I have, like, four muscle guys bringing me around. Yeah, no, it's still really weird. I've been talking so much. Yes. My voice is starting to go a little bit. But it's just trippy because, honestly, I thought I'd be gone day 12, day 18. And then all of a sudden, day 27, I'm like, come on, I wanted to go to Cape Town. And it didn't happen, and God, I'm king of the jungle. It's just weird.
It is weird, and because, like, you're usually reporting on celebrities, you know what I mean? And then suddenly, it's like sort of, you've got sort of, the tables turned, it's been flipped around, and now you are you're the biggest celebrity in Australia.
Oh, God, oh, yeah. Please. I don't know about that. I will say, because I honestly, and you know, you guys have known me forever, I never think of myself as being a celebrity. And so when I was in there, I was like, okay, that's a mistake, A. And then B, I think because I really love talking to people and hearing their stories that somehow I got in every single shot. You know? And I'm like, tell me more. But it's honestly because there was no Netflix, there was no 10 Play. You had to rely on your own stories and other people's. And
so it was just no TV.
I know.
But also guts. That bathtub challenge, that just was the single most terrifying thing I've ever seen. How did you actually muster up the courage to face that?
Did you see me? There was no courage.
I know, but you sat there and you said, okay, yep. What were you saying to yourself?
I was just saying, please, dear Lord, don't let me fall to a horrible, crashing, painful death.
Okay, right. Because that would have kept you calm.
Yeah. So it was just phenomenal. But the worst was the electrocution. Not once, but twice. It really hurt. I swear to God, it hurt.
But it was really funny to watch.
It was.
It was so funny.
You were up for everything. You became a bit of a confidant to a few people in the jungle. You were hilarious. You are on our show for the rest of the morning, which we're so excited about. And we're going to chat a little more with you about your jungle experiences throughout the show. Richard Reid, everyone.
Oh, my God.
huge thank you to the strong team at Purebred Fitness. They're under Uber Muscles on your app.
But they look a little bit like you after you come out of the jungle.
You know what? They're on retainer. I'm off at noon, so stick around, boys.
I love it.